We are in a tension. They will do their business tension. Okay, guys, this is the let's repeat. So what I want to do is I'll close this Jupyter. I will open it again for you. Okay, so what to do? Type Jupyter. Very simple. Okay, so open it. Okay, and go through this. Try it in your browser. Okay, try it in your browser. Click here. So there are a lot of things are there. Try Classic Notebook. Try Jupyter Lab. Like the separate is there. Okay, Ruby, Kotlin. Okay, Jupyter with a scheme. Something is there. Or Julia. I don't know. This is a completely new. You Voila. I don't know. So that's the thing. So you can directly go with the Classic Notebook or Jupyter Lab. I'm going to Jupyter Lab. To see what is there. So it is a online IDE type. Okay, so nowadays people who are learning ML, machine learning and all, they'll start teaching with this one only. So better to habituate to use this one. Okay, so what I'm doing is, so I'm selecting this notebook demo file. It is a notebook like this. Okay, Python. So it is showing a untitled kind of stuff. If you want to save it, you can save it also. Like this is the save button. Just like if you click it, save completed, or you can rename it. I think rename is possible. Check it. The rename. So I put my line Latif. Once you close this one, it won't save anywhere. So that's another thing. So be careful that one. So here it is, save. So first of all, print. Okay. Print statement. So print, welcome to Python. So just a print statement. So then here is a button, execution button. Can you able to run it? So you got an output here. Okay, if in case like you want to do like a same example I'm doing. So A is equal to 20, B is equal to 50. A plus B. I put a statement, simple print. A plus B, just for testing purpose only. Okay, this is three statements I given: A value, B value, and a print statement. So I'm executing 35. Now, if you want to change the values, like I make this one as a 25, I make this one as a 150. Okay, now this is the value. So we can edit and we can start executing like that. You can keep doing it. For example, what to do? L1 is equal to a list. Print L1. It is a printed. So you don't need to do of IDLE installation and all. So anytime, anywhere you can able to access, but it won't store in your PC anyway. If you want, you can share it. You can create the file and you can download the file. So I am trying to download it, whether it is download or not. Okay, that is a good one. And here it is. Save it. Open in folder. Okay, so maybe you are trying to execute with if it is installed, or otherwise you can upload it. Okay, you can save it. I will try to open with Notepad. If it is open, then it is good.
Here it is, it open. Yeah, you can't read the data inside. Okay, so because it's not installed locally, otherwise you can share it or maybe you can upload it into GitHub. Okay, like that. So this is your Jupyter. So how it is, you can able to do it. I think you got the point. The next is locally installed Python, just like I installed a Python in my system, already installed. This is the 3.10, new one is already installed. Okay, so if you miss yesterday's one, it is already in YouTube, but for you, how to download, at least I will tell. Installation is always seen. Okay, you can download it in your locally. And maybe there is a lot of other ways to access it. Even include, I said, Netacad. Netacad is also good. There's, you will directly will get a console beside. You can only install in your system. So you can see the downloads. You can directly see 3.10. But if you click it, it may download 32 bit or a 64 bit. I don't know. So what to do? So go to the downloads and Windows. Go to downloads and go to Windows here. Click Windows. So you can see latest Python 3 release, Python 3.10.1. So you can go to download Windows installer 32 bit, download Windows installer 64. This is a full package. This is embed package, means small package will download, again it will download from the internet. Okay, so better to download directly like this. If you click it, it will download this one. Already I downloaded. Okay, already I downloaded, so we have to free download manager. Where I downloaded in app folder. So here it is, Python, this one. So I have a previous editions also. So Python 3.1.1. So if you double click it, so select all the options, no need to do anything, select all the options and next install only. So no need to do anything, just double click open. Otherwise I have to uninstall my package because it's already installed now. Otherwise I will do it, no problem.
Yes sir.
Which one? Have to uninstall it?
Yes,
okay.
Sir.
So remember, you have to download this one. Okay. So how to uninstall it?
Yes sir.
How to uninstall it? Yes sir. Tell me one by one. I open control panel at least one step. First step I done. Tell me second step.
Sir, I have to install it. Programs and features.
Very good. Next. So I have two Pythons. Three Pythons. Okay. This is Python, the latest one. This is the older one. So first of all, I will install the both the things. Okay, first we will uninstall it, and we will say yesterday only I installed.
Sir, what is the difference between 64 bit and 32 bit?
It's an application only. 64 is more compatible with 64 bit systems. Direct understanding. 32 bit again, it required a WoW 64. Windows on Windows 64 service, through that one only understand, means my processor, my operating system 64 bit, and your application, our the application is 64 bit, means same bit length, means the program code instruction length, data length is 64 bit. So direct understanding is there. Okay, length of instruction is same, but if I use a 32 bit on a 64 bit, so 64 bit machine, it's difficult to understand the program or a instruction or a data. So again, it need a service called a WoW 64. So better always compatible one. So like that.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Actually, I will. Explanation is there, but at least minimum explanation. In the terms of application. So anyway, it is removing. Meanwhile, okay. So you ask a very good question. So it will tempt me. Okay. So see here it is. This is 32. In 32-bit machines, compatibilities. I'm not taking anything, just a compatibilities. 32-bit means CPU 32-bit type. Operating system must be 32-bit operating system. And drivers. What are the drivers? Your hardware devices like a audio chip, video chips, network drivers, okay, chip drivers, anything, the drivers, okay, video drivers or anything, the drivers must be 32-bit. And next one is application. Applications must be 32-bit. Important is everything must be same bit number only. But in application, we have another choice is you can use one step lower, that is called a 16-bit. Application can run on a 32-bit system. But these are all 32-bit. Compulsory. No other choice. But this is, we have a choice like a old one is also possible. It can be compatible, but if you want to run 32-bit app on 32-bit PC, okay, bit, okay, no problem. But you want to run 16-bit program or application on 32-bit, system will slow, okay, because this PC don't understand 32-bit, it's lower bit, so obviously don't understand. Higher bit, incompatible. Lower bit, okay, but there is a problem, okay, so like that. So it's still uninstalling, we'll see. To help running the 16-bit on a 32-bit, we have to use a program called WoW32. Okay, for example, I have a 2003 server, which is 32-bit. On this server, I have a SQL server, MS SQL server, Microsoft SQL. This is Windows server. Okay, something like maybe 2003. But it is 16-bit, but it's not 32-bit. I got a 16-bit one. Difficult 16-bit app on 32-bit PC. It's very difficult to run. So what we need? WoW32 for SQL. Okay. So what is WoW32? Means Windows 16 on Windows 32. Meaning is Windows 16 on Windows 32. So this is a program, but this is a program. So using this program, so your 32-bit machine can understand 16-bit application. Okay, even though bit incompatibilities are there, but if you use the same bit, more compatibility. See again, 64-bit PC means CPU 64, OS 64, drivers you install must be 64 only. Without 64, it won't work. Next, point is application. Must be 64. Okay, but there is a slight chance you can run 32-bit. Okay, 32-bit application also, you can run a 64-bit PC. But problem is, system will get slow. Application or a system will get little slow, okay, but you don't feel that thing, okay. If in case if you are using a Linux, and Unix, compulsory bit compatibility means 64 means 64 only, 64 system, 64 bit application. But in Windows, it's not like that. Windows 7 onwards, 7, 8, 10, 2008 server onwards, there is a service called a WoW64 service. It is comes with your operating system directly. If you install 32-bit application, it mostly it will work. Mainly for certain only few applications may give you problem, may show it is incompatible, but mostly normal any application, 32-bit application can easily run on 64-bit PC, okay, because of WoW64. Meaning is WoW32 on WoW64, by default it is running in your system. Especially you don't need to download like a previous example, you can run on it. Compatibility. Is it completed or not? I'm installing 3.9.5 also. This launcher also you can able to uninstall it. This is the plugin for Notepad++. It means if you don't want any other IDEs, so you can use Notepad++ also. Notepad, you can do it. Notepad++ also, you can write a program. It's a basic IDE type, plugins using. You have already Eclipse, then you can add a PyDev as a plugin. So you can write a Python program in a Eclipse. Even in a NetBeans also, you can add it. Okay, omnipresent, very good. Yeah, here is this Omni 15.
Sir, I'm getting error while installing Python in the virtual machine, sir.
Which error?
Sir, it's like 0x8007003. The system cannot find the path specified, sir.
Maybe there is a problem. In the virtual machine?
Yes, sir, in the virtual machine.
You won't get that kind of problem in virtual machines. You downloaded an application in your physical machine or in a virtual machine directly?
So first, I have downloaded it in physical machine, sir.
Then you are installing in a virtual machine, right?
Yes.
So just clean up once and restart the PC and try to install it.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, guys, listen carefully. I want to tell very simple things. Okay. If you understand this 64 32 bit, it's okay. If you don't understand, also okay. No. See, here it is. Very simple thing is, to become a programmer, what we need? What is the main property of to become a programmer?
Think like programmer.
Think like a programmer. Yeah, we are programmers, then always we think like a programmer. So you must have a property of copy and paste the code. Okay. Next, search in Google and understand Stack Overflow. Okay, So these are the main properties. You should know how to search your errors and how to search in a Stack Overflow and how to fix your code with a Stack Overflow. Same thing. You are now become a programmer or an administrator. So, okay, whatever the title it is, either you become a programmer or maybe an administrator. So in ITS profile, there are a lot of things are there. Engineer, admin, so many people, names are there. But whatever it is, I'm telling, once you got an error, no need to panic. We have a system called a Google system. And there is a same kind of error. Lot of people are there. We are Indians, guys. Always think like a first Indian. You know, if you, there is a personality development thing is there. So like it is, you went to a, you know, coin box kind of stuff. Okay, like a weighing machine in a railway station earlier days, coin box, you put a coin and coin it, but you didn't get any weighing output. Okay, coin is wasted. You never told anybody, right? So meantime, someone came and they want to put a coin. So just you wait, let him put a coin. He's also not getting output. Yeah. What happened?
Explain in notepad, sir.
I'm not explaining anything now. I'm just frustrated now.
Sir is not teaching anything.
Yes. She's sleeping. Okay. See, we will wait. Someone will get a same error. Right? So that's the point. Someone will get a same error. So what we are doing it? Same thing. If you got an error, search if anybody is getting error, search anybody suggesting how to solve the problem. That is make you a very good admin. I want to be, how do you see yourself after 5 years? HR question. You want to become a good a network administrator or a system administrator or maybe a data center administrator, or I want to become a programmer, or I want to become a senior consultant. So to become what? To how to become that one, you must know how to search your errors and how to fix the errors. You must know it. That's the secret. Open secret. Okay. So finally, as per your request, finally I installed my Python. So now I don't have a Python. First one is IDLE. Still it is showing something because it's already I removed it. Next is Python 3.8, still it is there or what? Okay, so my control panel, so refresh the control, this one. Okay, find out where the Python and other Pythons are available. This is a PyCharm. Python launcher is there, so just I am going to uninstall that one also. So here is another important. So anyway, we are here, so I'm going to not this one. Okay, here it is.
You told you will discuss 1 hour on virtualization.
Yeah, we are here. So yeah, it's a troubleshooting, you know, so it is also interview question only. Means what I'm going to teach you, that is also interview question. And oh, what happened? My system got fixed. Time waste. So 3-2, now it is 10-4. Okay, let's look at here. What is registry? What is registry? Anyone having any idea? It's okay. What is this registry?
when you are install, sorry, not only install, registry is like a register only, just a register, like school register, attendance register. It's a register. Registry is a just a register. It register your entire PC details. Your entire PC details. What are the details? Your hardware information. Okay. Operating system. Okay. OS information. Operating system information. Your application information. Okay. User. Okay. And a user application means if you have a multiple users, so each user may be having a some users having a same application, both can able to use it. Some users cannot use same application. So like that, it's like I created another user, the other user having a separate application format. So that like that, it can be a separate. So your application details also it shows. You know, you install a demo version. So demo version is like a maybe 15 days demo version, only works for a 15 days. Now 15 days completed, you uninstall application and you try to install your demo app. You try to install a demo application, so you should get a 15 days again. 15 days, next 15 days you can able to work on it. Okay, next 15 days it should work, but it won't happen. It will tell it is finished. So we'll take another timeline, otherwise like a you install a demo version, it worked for a 15 days. So first day you install should be finished by 15th day, right? But what you done on 10th day, you uninstalled it. On 10th day, you install the application. You uninstall the application on 10th day. Then once you are uninstalled it, what you done? Try install the application. You are trying to install the application. So you think you'll get a next 15 days. You'll get a next 15 days. After installation, again, you will get it. 10th day means 25th day. 25th of December, you'll get it. Okay. So expiry date is 25th. Because 10 days completed. So you think it is next 15 days, you'll get it. But no. Why? The registry will put a date management. Because of first day installed this demo version, okay, and you uninstall after 10 days, okay, in uninstall it after 10 days and you try to install, what happened? You'll get only 5 days only. Okay, you'll get only 5 days. After that one, still it is this one only. Why? Because of registry. Why? Because of registry. Next, I am opening some file. Here it is. Something. And there is a PDF file is there. Just I double click on that PDF. Or maybe I can open Notepad. Okay. And I have opened my PDF. Okay, so how my system knows open with a particular application? If I open this particular .txt file or a .pdf file or a .docx file, okay, how my system knows if I open this kind of file, it should be open with the particular application. So how it is knows? Because of in registry
it is there in a registry. It is a .txt. Any file open with .txt, open with a notepad only, open with a wordpad only, we open with a Adobe Reader only, open with a Microsoft Office only. How it is knows? It depends upon the registry. Registry having that information here. Okay, so not only this is just one example, this is another example I told. A lot of examples also there. So whenever versions, for example, I have a application with a version 4. My application is a version 4 application. Now I want to install application with a version 3. What it will tell? Okay. So already installed application 4. Now I try to install application version 3. What it will tell? Newer version available. Newer version available. Okay, unable to install. So how it is knows the newer version is available? Because in registry, so this application name with a version name, it is already there. So it will compare between these two things. It is already there, and why should I install it? So like that, it will be, will give you output. All Python things are done. So only this is a pie chart. So you are not belongs to that one. Okay. So this is a registry editor. So how to open a registry editor also I will tell. So go to the run command. Best is go to run command. Regedit. Type regedit. Okay. It is .exe, not msc. It's a regedit. It's a .exe. So click yes. Then you can see. So what I have done. So go to run. The run. So type regedit. regedit. .exe. Without exe also it will open. Okay. So you can see the registry editor like this. This is the registry editor. You can find here it is root class, means extensions you can find. Like a .py if you want. mnpoqp. So mnyyyyy. Okay. PS means PowerShell. PY, right? So PY. Okay. So nothing is there for a PY extension. Okay. For nothing is there for a PY extension currently. Maybe once I installed Python, maybe it will shows. Okay. I said PS for a PowerShell, right? So where is the PS? PS, PD, PP, PNO, PQ, PP, RS, yes. PS or this one. So it is also showing like that only. Okay. PSD. It is internally something this. TXT, you can find TXT, DOCS, like that. This is the current user. I log in with which user? The current user's related information. Current user's related information. Control panel, applications, printers, or everything is related to current user only. This is a local machine, means your hardware, like a BCD, about a boot system, hardware. SAM means login information, username, password informations, security, software, and this one. This is a installed software information, which what are the applications installed in your PC. Okay. Users, what are the users in your account? Okay, like that. Okay, and here it is current configuration. Current configuration, nothing is there. Only these things only, but important anyway. Class root means dot extensions, they're relevant. The their relevant applications. Current user applications and their environmental setup. Okay, local machines is about entire your system, your hardware, your account information, your security login information, system information. So everything you can see from here on. You can go to the software, find out which software you are belongs to it. Okay, you can delete that entry, but you need a related kind of stuff, you see. So Python 3.10, that information is still, it is there. Even if I uninstall that application, this is there. Okay, why it is there? Okay, that related information, some information is there. Why it is there? Because I have to restart to clean up, or I have to clean up by using CC cleaner. Okay, so because I can't restart now, so class will be stopped immediately. What is this? Server error connection. Okay, no problem. Okay, so I cannot restart my PC to clean up. So after uninstallation of any application, you must restart. So this is about your registry. What is the registry? It stores the information of entire PC. Stores information of entire PC. What is entire PC? Hardware information, operating system, user applications, okay, and application information also. Others are just for an explanation. How to open a registry editor? Go to run, type regedit. Regedit. R-E-G edit. So that is a registry. See? This is how we are diverted from there to here. Okay. I must restart after an installation, and I'm going to install it again. Guys, I'm not downloading again because already I told how to download. So I'm directly doing it. So first of all, I'm going to this. So already I told, go to python.org, downloads, Windows. Here you have to go to Windows. So because mine is a Windows 10, so I'm using, and 64-bit, so I'm using the latest version only. So download Windows installer 64, just this part, click here, click this one, you will download into your system. Okay, so mostly it is in your downloads only. Go to your downloads. Okay, click here, go to your downloads. You can find in a downloads only, but I downloaded into different folder. Okay, I download into different folder in my G drive separately, so I am installing from there only. Okay, so this is a Python 10.1, double click. Okay, okay. So in a Python it is quite easy, just it will appear the setup window, select everything, both the things. You can choose the first one or you can choose the second one, customize installation, anything is okay, but I am going to second one only. I am going to second one only, customize installation, and all our check marks are there, so check, make sure everything is checked. We don't need to worry about anything because it's a TK enter, no problem with the TK enter. And PIP must required, because in future you need a NumPy by pandas like that, you need it, so compulsory we need it. Maybe you need a GUI gaming, GUI programming, may required to install a PIP thing, so compulsory you must need a PIP. Next, so here it is, you can go click on install, but it is installed in your local directory, not in a program files. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm selecting this one, install for all users in my system. I have only one user, but you change this one. Program files means 64-bit application. This is 64-bit application. That's it, it's a program files. If this is a 32-bit, it shows program files x86. And I'm selecting everything because I think it's a debugging symbols kind of stuff is also coming. It's okay. Select everything. Select environmental variables also. Next, install, click yes and wait, let it install. So that's it. It killed almost 1 hour. But no problem. But without installing into your PC, you can't do anything simply. Not only this one, guys. Usually, I already told there is a video for Visual Studio Code, how to install a video Visual Studio Code, how to add a plugin also. It's a very lightweight. I don't know what is your motivation of learning kind of stuff, guys. Without knowledge, you do nothing. Okay. Whether you paid an amount or maybe you are got a recommendation letter or whatever it is. In industry, you want to live, you have to learn. You must have a knowledge and you have to keep up the knowledge. Okay. That in Cognizant. In Cognizant, directly the director, all these people telling directly, there is no layoff. Means they don't fire anybody until unless they are not upgrading their knowledge. Okay, they are not upgrading, means get out from here on. Very simple. Without knowledge, you are useless. How much communication skills? Communication skills only for entry purpose only. Knowledge is the main thing. Okay. Even myself, I can't live in this industry, first of all. I have to go to any roadside institute. So, telling about hardware networking, that means only how I'm living here by teaching. What are the technology they said? I know a guy is a 14 years experience, and I asked something like he got a doubt, and what is his doubt? He didn't understand what this virtual machines and we got only 2 years experience candidates. The 14 years complete hardware side only. So no upgradations. It depends upon situations, but never think there is something is not useful. Keep learning, that's it. Okay, so I will close this one. Okay, so that is a Jupyter. You can use a Jupyter, and also there is a lot of online consoles are there. As you can, if you have a doubt in this one, like you can go to Google browser. Okay, this is extensions are there. Go to settings or extension, direct option is there, no? Yeah, extensions manager. Okay, search here Python. No result found. Okay, it is not there. So later you have to download maybe Python extension kind of stuff. Okay. Python is a very easy language and it won't load in your much space in your PC. Okay. Let it install. Anybody having meanwhile any doubts? How is your preparation? Interview preparation. If you are waiting for a syllabus to complete and preparation, then we will attend the interview. That won't happen. I'm telling directly. Understand. So our next week interview, next syllabus will complete it. Then I will start preparation for 2 days. Then I will attend the interview for 3 days. That won't happen. You fail in interview. Very simple.
So okay. We are getting very much less time, sir, to prepare.
Prepare daily, 24 hours we have in a day. This is not academy. That's why I'm telling you. You're telling correct answer. You said that is the point. Okay. So what my point is, we don't have a time. We don't get a time. If you got a time, then it is very high time. Means like a 2-3 weeks, you will get a gap. If you want a time, they will give you 2-3 weeks. That will be more delay. That's the problem. Okay. So important thing is prepare daily. And if I got a chance, then I will tell revision manner, like a topic wise revision, which is I told last time, but it is not happened properly, but still it is that one. And a very important thing is, guys, never think this one as a academy. Still, I know a lot of people are in the academy mode only. Academic, like a BTech type only. So, sir, BTech, no problem. Tomorrow is an exam. Tonight, I will open the book and I will finish it, and tomorrow I will write an exam. This is not even an exam also. This is not a one subject. Multiple subject, guys. you may not realize. It's not single subject. Python, interview, you will pass. Server interview, you will pass. But it is all mixing. No one knows what question from which corner you will get it. All are basic questions only, but still you don't understand. It's keep topics or changes, right? Sometimes like they will take it from the cloud, maybe from DevOps, or maybe from server, maybe from networking. So sometimes they will go depth of one particular subject. Okay? Based on your interview, based on your speaking levels. Okay? So my point is, it is not like your academies. If you are in academy mode, please get out from the academy mode. Come out from the academy mode. Get out means come out from the academy mode. It is not academy, not like a test book or all-in-one reading. Okay? Keep practicing, keep discussing with your friends. So you will get to know how to speak the answers easily. I tried so many times, my students are selected. They got a very good outcome. Not in online, but even online also, there is a few batches are done, this kind of stuff. Few are not less than anyone. Okay, that's a different point. Okay, never think like, what if we fail in this interview? You will get another chance, but don't wait for another chance. Do it in a first chance only. You got a chance to prove yourself, that's enough. Okay, that is enough. So my point is, study daily, practice, take out the interview questions, discuss with your friends. There is this very simple Google Meet is there. No need to pay, no need to do anything. Simple, open it and start asking questions. You will get to know. It's a very simple, easy way to prepare. This is how we can install our Python. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is, I am typing IDLE. This is your IDLE 3.10. It is showing. So just I select it. Okay. Initially, once you are installed, you have to select and try how to work with this one. So anyway, print statement. Okay. So anything, just like, or maybe you want to run a file, open a file. So like open. Okay, something I put it, so I'm not, so demo file. See, this is file opening. This is file opening. I've written some code here, so I'm executing it. Run Python shell or a run module something. So I go to Python shell like this. So what are the code here? It will run. So where it is running? It is taking too much size on the screen. But where is output? Why it is not running? Okay. Yeah, it is running here. So I select run module, this module. Okay. So it is doing like date, numbers, so total output. Okay, like this we can able to run a file, or you can create a new file from here also. See, new file. This is a just empty file. Okay, I'm writing something like, normally print statements, all these things we can easily do it, but if you go to if loop kind of stuff. Okay, if 10 is greater than 20,
inch. 10 is okay. 10 is greater than 20. Okay. Else. Print. And is not greater than 20. Something. Just for a testing purpose. Okay. So I given a if loop. Okay. In this manner, in here, you can't, it is not much easy to type more than one line. But here, whenever you want to type this kind of stuff, like a more than one line kind of stuff, you can do it in a file. So you must save this one before you execute it. Okay. Properly save it. Properly save it. Save it in a desktop or D drive or E drive kind of stuff only. Don't save it somewhere and ask me, sir, I saved somewhere. I don't know where it is located. Okay. So don't save like that. So I saved it and I'm going to run the module. See, it is 10 is not greater than 20. Like that. So you don't require any IDEs and all kind of stuff. Okay. Just you can type a program here and also you can execute here and you can see the output from here also. That is also, there's a possibility. So this is a simple Python installation and work with a Python. If you put an exit button, so you won't get exited directly. So you have to use exit like this, or you have to put a control D to exit. Guys, one more thing, there is no up and down like your Linux kind of stuff won't work here. Okay, so you have to type every time, every command you have to do it. Okay, so like this. This is the one thing in a Python how to work on it. Second one is you can go to cmd command prompt. So type python, automatically you will get a that IDLE screen in the your cmd also. Okay, depends upon you how to open it. Okay, then you can type your whatever the command you want to type here. So for example, always a print statement is not good. Okay. 120 is greater than 35. True. Okay. Okay. Like that. So it's like 34 is greater than 6. Like this. False. So like that, we can able to do it. This is one. Next one is like you can run a Python file also. Like you know the Python file, then you can also run from it. So e colon slash see, you have to type properly. It is in e drive slash c8.py. okay, can verify whether it is there or not. Yes, it is under projects. Sorry. Okay. I run this program which is I written earlier. Okay, I run this program directly. So this is a another way of running the program. Okay, in another hand, so you can use Visual Studio Code. It is a empty console. It is an IDE, but it is a empty one. So by installing, already I told there is a installation and how to add a plugin. Already I done. I'm not doing anything now. Okay. See, here it is. This is the empty one. So like this, it will be there. So what to do? You have to open a Python file, or you can able to create a new Python file. So yeah, it is coming. New file. Go to new file and type some command like a print. Hello, VS Code.
it won't execute anything because I didn't give any extension. You don't know which program it is. So I have to save it. Okay, I have to save this one. So it will ask how to save it. So then I put a name, search the extension. You can do anything, Java, Go language, C, C++, anything you can do here. PHP, P means Python is here. Where is the Python? PowerShell is there. Python is missing. Then I will know extension files. So and another hand, so you must know how to save it here. Okay, so when you see it is a seeing a PY. So it is automatically understands which extension it is. If it is already there, good. If it is not there, it will pop up. So use Python kind of stuff, then it automatically execute. I'm trying to execute this one. So by clicking here, it may not, we'll see. Yeah, it is loading Python 3.9. See, it is 3.9 is my old one. But it is not there. Old one is not there. New one is not there. I just installed new one. It is does not understand the new one. That's it is showing an error because of I don't have a Python 3.9 in my system currently. It cannot able to execute. Next, I'm going to CMD. This is first setting is important in a programming. -V. Oh shit. Python version. Okay, so my CMD is understand which Python is 3.10.1 is there, but my VS Code is not understanding, or maybe my PyCharm is not understanding. So you have to do few things here. Let's look at this one. Environmental variables. This is a environmental variables. Type here environment. You will get a edit the system environmental variables. What is the environmental variables? What is the environmental variables? Environmental variable means where is your program? Where is your program? Location of the program. Home directory of your program. That's it. So when you run a program, so or when you run something on a particular program or a Java or maybe Python or maybe PDF or anything, just or a SQL, so it should run, means system should understand, right? Through some application it will run. So where is that application? Where is the location of application? Where is the executable file for that application? Application is there, but where is the executable file for application? That is we have to set up. So I open my system properties. This is environmental variables. Click here. So I added so many things here, but I am going down. Already I said add a path. So I will verify once again. So edit. So go to this path, system variables, path, edit. You can see it is 3.10 means 3.10 means 3.10 only. 3.10, both are already added. So I no need to add it, but this is also added. That's why system is confusing between 3.9 and 3.10. So this is not required because it's not there in my system. I'm going to delete this one. My old one, I'm deleting. And I'm keeping. If in case, if it is not there, you have to add it. You have to add it. Like a click new, you have to type this thing. Or maybe you can use a browser also. You can use it. Okay. This is already there. I'm not doing anything. Otherwise, click on a new. And type it like a C:// program files. No need to do like that. So I will tell very simple way. Go to your machine, see try where you install, while you are installing it shows the link, right? It where while you're installing it shows the link, so that's why I check it 2 to 3 times. So while you install, you must remember what you done. Program files, C:\programfiles, this is 310, this is the folder I installed it. So first copy this one, new, paste here, okay, click OK, that's it. So I'm not doing it, just how to do it, because I got a python.exe location is here only. Python.exe location is here only. One more is important, that is script related. PIP extensions are here, PIP executable files are here. So copy this link and path, edit, new, and paste here. Okay, like that you have to do it. That is a environmental variables. If as you say, like if I use the virtual machine, in general earlier days I use the virtual machines to explain all these things, so it is from look like a explain from the scratch only. Now I can't do that one. So oh yeah, I done that one, so try again. Now it is done, see. So what is the mistake earlier? My here it is thinking, still it is thinking 3.9, now it is thinking 10. Okay, so this is my Python execution. Okay, so I am using this py code, and how to add a extension is important, right? So this is the extensions. Okay, this is the extension. If you want to add it, just type Python. So I think I installed this one, Python. Okay, this is the thing I installed. So you will get like this install button. Just you have to click install. Python for VS Code. Array. I install this one. Pylance. IntelliSense. Pylance. Like this. This is the thing I installed actually. Okay. You just install it. Okay. So just type a Python here. So you will find a Python from the Microsoft official one. So IntelliSense like this. Once you are installed, you will get it disabled or installed. You can uninstall it if you don't want. You can uninstall it also. You want to run a Java, also you can search for a Java package. Okay, so try like this. Extension for Java, I installed this one also. Debug for a Java, Maven for a Java. These are all I installed it. Okay, test runner for Java, like that. Okay, guys. So this is about your. Okay. So this is about info packages and are not required. Extensions, close extensions not required. So these are all extensions. So once you are added, so automatically you'll get executed. So this is the VS Code, very lightweight for opening, closing, for running simple program, like only for Python, only for Java, or only one Python Java, like one or two. Okay, if you see, this is Eclipse, will take lot of time to open and run. It will take time. PyCharm, same thing, it will take time to run, open kind of stuff also. So these are all about your installation of Python. Okay, test installation of Python and write simple code using IDLE is a best option. Okay, another one, I already told VS Code, how to use it. Want to download a VS Code also, I will give you the link. This is the another list. Visual Studio Code. It is a empty console. Some people are habituated to use Atom kind of stuff. You can use Atom if you want it. I don't like the Atom, so that's why I'm not using it. Okay. This VS Code is an empty console. It does not have anything. So can I use atom which I already, yes, you can use atom, no problem. Okay, there is nothing like you should use this one only. It is not like that. Anything you can use it. People who are not using others, I suggest best start with a VS Code. No confusion, because I didn't get confusion in a VS Code, but atom I got confused. Okay, so download like this. So if you go for a like this also, you can do it. Windows 64 user installer, just stable, click here. Just if you click here, automatically, thanks for downloading like this, automatically start downloads. Okay, once it is downloaded, what to do? Click on this Python here, the same screen only, in this screen only, click on Python. Just Python only. Yeah, it is rotating there. You can also see how in action, intelligent code, compilation, first step, what we can able to do it. Start habituated to use one. So we'll go with tutorials then. Okay, so Python with a, get started with the Python in a VS Code. So how to add extensions, how to install, how to install from like that, you will get it. How to verify. Okay, like this is the one. Yesterday I already downloaded, so no need to worry about it. Okay, yesterday only I downloaded this VS Code again, but I didn't do it. Okay, so you can follow the instructions if you want it. Okay, how to add a file, how to type a print, okay, how to add a extension. Already it is there in a video also there, so you can try and fix it. I think I forwarded that one also. So this is all about your Python, and we'll start the Python coding now. You'd wasted time up to 4:30. Take a break, guys.